dear students, in today's video, I'm going to solve your doubts. Some students have asked me doubts on the WhatsApp about round number 7. So see few of them. See here, question number 33. Round 7, question number 33. What was that question? In a library, 1/6 of books are Marathi, while 1/5 books are Hindi, and remaining 950 books are of English. Find the total number of books in the library. Now see, this is a question based on the fraction. Okay, so we have solved this type of questions. What is given? Books in library. Books of different subjects which are available in the library, that is given. If you see Marathi, how many books of Marathi are there? 1 upon 6. Whereas Hindi, books of Hindi are 1 upon 5. And remaining books are of English. Remaining 950 books are of English. Means books of English are 950. Now if you observe here, there are books of three subjects, Marathi, Hindi and English. And here in the problem, books of Marathi and Hindi are given in the form of fraction, whereas books of English are given in exactly number. How many books of English are there? That is given exactly. Means 950 books are there, but books of Marathi and Hindi, they are not given in exactly number. They are given in the form of fraction. Okay, so what is the question? We have to find the total number of books in that library. Okay, so while solving this type of question, what to do? First, these two fractions are given, no? Make their denominator same, as we do in the addition and subtraction of fraction. We make denominators same. Similarly, here also let us make their denominator same. Now see, in the first 1 upon 6, denominator is 6. Here denominator is 5, correct? So to make them same, 1 upon 6 and 1 upon 5. What is their LCM? Their LCM is 30. Okay, 6 5 is 30. So here to make here 30, we need to multiply by 5, and here to make here 30, we need to multiply by 6. So we got 5 1 is 5 upon 30, and here 6 1 is 6 upon 30. So when we make their denominator same, we got 1 upon 6, 5 is, and 5 is, that is 5 upon 30, and here to make here denominator 30, we need to multiply by 6. That is 6 1 6, 6 5 is 30. Okay. Now denominators are same, 30, 30. So see here, denominator is 30 means what you know? Denominator is 30 means what you know? If we consider that total number of book as a whole, one whole, total number of books are considered as a one whole, then that one whole is divided into 30 equal parts. 30 equal parts, that we see. Total number of books are divided into how many equal parts? 30 equal parts. As denominator is 30, so total number of books are divided into 30 equal parts. Okay, means total parts, equal parts are 30. Understand? Out of that, parts of Marathi are 5 and parts of Hindi are 6. So if you add these two parts, 5 and 6, means Marathi and Hindi together, then we are getting parts of Marathi and Hindi together. If you add the parts of Marathi and Hindi, how much we are getting? 5 plus 6, that is 11. Means out of 30 equal parts, Marathi and Hindi have 11 equal parts, okay? 11 parts. And remaining parts will be, there is only another, only one subject is there is, that is English, okay? So, out of 30, 11 parts of Marathi and Hindi, and remaining parts will be of English, okay? So, parts of English will be, parts of English are, how to find parts of English? Total parts are 30, so from 30 let us subtract parts of Hindi and Marathi, that is 11, so remaining 30 minus 11 we get 19. 19 parts are of English. Understand? Okay, I have not, generally we draw here figure, but I have not drawn figure because denominator is the 30 and 30 parts to show in the figure, it's not reasonable, okay? So, what I have done here subtraction, means this, okay? So, now 30 minus 11, 19 got, 19 parts are of English. So, English is equal to, see, 19 parts. But 19 parts means, we know that exactly how many books of English are there. We know that 950. So this 19 parts means 950 books. 19 parts means 950. So using this, we will find for one part means how many. One part means how many. See, remember, we have to find 30 parts means how many books. Because 30 parts means total books, correct? So 30 parts means how many, that we have to find. For that, we here we have got 19 parts means 950 books. So one part means, how to find one part? Here unitary method, if you remember unitary method, given for 19, asking for 1. Let us divide this 950 by 19. So we will get here 91 by 19. 95 is 95 and 0 is 0, 50. So one part means 50 books. One part means 50 books. So such how many total parts are there? So total 30 parts means 50 into 30. 50 books into 30, that is, these two zeros will come here and 5 3s are 15. 1500 books are there. Total 1500 books are there in that library. Understand? And if it is asked to find Marathi books separately and Hindi books separately, then also we can find. Okay, well, English books are 950 and remaining books are of Marathi and Hindi. Okay. In this way, we have to solve this type of question. Remember, this type of question will definitely be asked in the exam for 4 or 3 marks or 5 marks sometimes. Okay? Next tau is, now see question number 31. Rupees 500 at 6% per annum for 2 years and rupees 400 at 5% per annum for 3 years were borrowed. Find the difference between the amount after the expiry of the respective periods. Two cases are here. This is the problem of interest. Two cases are there. Case 1, case 2. Okay. In the first case, principal is rupees 500, rate of interest is rupees, rate of interest is 6% per annum, okay, and number of years is 2 years, correct? And here in the second case, principal is rupees 400, rate of interest is 5% per annum and number of years are 3. Okay, what we have to find? Find the difference between the amount after expiry of respective periods. Means with these details we will find the amount and we have to find the difference between the both the amounts. Understand? In both the cases. So you know to find amounts, first we need to find simple interest, because amount, how the amount is found? Principal plus interest is equal to amount. So to find amount, we need to find simple interest. And the formula for simple interest is P into N into R upon 100. Here also same, simple interest is equal to P into N into R upon 100. Okay. So see here, P is 500 into 2 years into 6 upon 100. Similarly here, P is 400 into N is 3 into 5 upon 100. Okay. So let's cut both these 0, 0. Yes, see, 6 2s are 12, 12 5s are 60. So interest is rupees 60. Here 3 5s are 15, 15 4s are 60. Here also interest 60. Interest is same. Okay, let's find amount in both the cases. You know, amount is principal plus interest. So principal is here rupees 500 plus interest is rupees 60. Rupees 560. Okay, and here again amount is equal to principal plus interest. Principal is rupees 400 here and interest is 60, that is 460. This is the amount. Now difference between the amount, 560 minus 460. So what is difference? 560 minus 460, 100. Okay, 100 is the answer. So the option number second, 100. Okay. See here, question number 29. A lake is full of water to three fifths of its total depth. Which is 5 meter 40 centimeter. At what height from the bottom does water level stand? Once again I read. A lake is full of water to 3 fifth of its total depth, which is 5 meter 40 centimeter. At what height from the bottom does the water level stand? Now see. Now lake is full of water till 3 fifth of its total depth. Or 3 fifth. Lake is full till 3 feet of total depth. Now 3 feet means what? 3 upon 5. Upon 5 means 5. If that lake is divided into 5 equal parts. Suppose this is the lake. For example, I am giving. This is the lake and the lake is divided into, suppose, 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 equal parts, then water is till 3 parts from bottom. Okay, till 3 parts. Now we have been given total height or total depth. Depth means height of that lake, 5 meter 40 centimeters. Total depth is 5 meter 40 centimeter. Let us convert this 5 meter 40 centimeter into all in centimeter. So 5 meter 40 centimeter means 540 centimeter. Okay. Means total depth, 5 equal parts means 540 centimeter. That is, see, 5 parts means 540 centimeter. Okay. Then one part means, this problem is same like that problem number 33. One part means 540 upon 5. Let us divide this total height into 5 parts. You will get height of or depth of each part. 5 1s are 5, 5 0s are 0, 5 8s are 40, 108 cm. This is depth of each part. Now let us see what is the question they have asked. The question is, at what height from the bottom does the water level stand? Now water is from bottom, water is these three parts. Okay, so that is only question, at what height does the water level stand? Now water is still three parts, means we have to find height of three parts. Height of one part is 108 cm. So three parts is equal to 108 cm into 3. So 3 8s are 24 to carry, 3 0s are 0 into 2, 3 1s are 3. 324 cm. Let us see what how the options are given. Options are given in meter and centimeter. Options are given in meter and centimeter, and this is whole in centimeter. So 324 centimeter means 3 meter 24 centimeter. Okay. So the height of or depth of the water from bottom is 3 meter 24 centimeter. Okay. Okay, now pause this video and write these three examples in your notebook. Let us see next examples. See here, there was one question, question number 35. It is, I think, from round number 6. Listen the question carefully. The length of rectangular room is 5 meter and breadth is 3 meter. Length and breadth of that rectangular room is given, that is 5 meter and 3 meter. Find the expenditure to paint the roof of the room at the rate of rupees 12 per square meter. Understand this? See here. The room is rectangular shape. Room is rectangular shape. Okay? Like this. Its length is 5 meter and breadth is 3 meter. Okay? Find the expenditure to paint the roof. Means this is room, correct? So we have to paint its roof, and for that per square meter cost is rupees 12. Then what is total expenditure? How much total rupees we have to spend for that? Understand that you have to find. See, remember, this type of questions are either based on area and perimeter. Area or perimeter. How to understand whether the question is of perimeter or area? For that, your concepts of perimeter and area should be clear. Now see, whenever we talk about area, this concept area is based or depend on the surface, right? Internal surface inside the object or inside the room or whatever. So when there is when we talk about the surface, that concept is related with the area. And when we talk about the boundary, only the border, boundary sides, that concept is related with the perimeter. So whenever this type of questions are there, if the questions are about perimeter, then what they will ask? They will ask about the wall, because wall be built on the border, or they will ask about the fencing. Fencing means compound. You know, compound also be built along with the border, correct? So for that fencing, how much wire is needed, or cost of wire per meter they will give, and they will ask to find the cost of whole wire needed for that compound fencing. Okay, this type of questions are based on the perimeter, whereas area, see, we have to paint the ceiling. Ceiling means whole surface of that room, whole surface of that ceiling. It is rectangular shape. So here we have to find area of rectangle. Understand? In another language, some questions will be this way. For leveling the ground or leveling the garden, okay? Or for gardening or cutting grass of that garden, they will give rate per square meter and they will ask to find total cost. So these type of concepts, terms like leveling or cutting the grass or painting or paving the tiles. You know, tiles we put on the whole surface, correct? We cover the room using tiles. That means talk about the surface of that room. So whenever these types of terms are there, we have to find their area. Okay. Again, one of the hint is when the rate is given per square meter. This square meter, you know, square meter or centimeter or kilometer, whatever. But this word square indicates that there we have to find area, because only in area we use the term square, square unit, that is square meter, square centimeter, whatever. If it is perimeter, then they will give only per meter, per centimeter, whatever. Okay, the word square will not be there. So this is also one of the hint by which we can understand whether we have to find area or perimeter. Now see here, in these, what they have given, length and breadth of that room is given, and what is the question? Find the expenditure to paint the roof of the room at the rate of rupees 12 per square meter. That means this concept is related to the area. So let us find first area of that room. Area of ceiling. And it is 6 feet, rectangular shape. So length multiplied by breadth, that is 5 meters into 3 meters, 15 square meters. So this is the area of that ceiling. Now rate of painting per square meter is rupees 12. Per square meter means this much area, for example, for this much area they are charging rupees 12. To paint this much area they are charging rupees 12. Then to paint this total area, how much total area means 15 square meter area. So rate of expenditure of painting total area, how much it is? 15 square meter. Per square meter, rupees 12. Then for 15 square meter, how much? What to do? Given for per means 1, asking for 15. Multiplication. So 15 into 12, that is 15 into 12, rupees 180, correct? 180. So to understand, per square meter rupees 12, then for 15 square meter we have to spend, our total expenditure is rupees 180. So this type of question is also often asked in the exam, various exams. Okay, so keep it in mind. Next, question number 36. I think it is in, this question is of round number 8, and this is also round number 8, question number 36. 7 students from a class collected flowers from a Dasera decoration as follows. One of them collected 43 flowers, means one student collected 43 flowers. Correct? Two students collected 29 flowers each. Two other students collected 23 flowers each. Okay, and 14 each by remaining ones. Now there are total 7 students, then how many remain? 1 plus 2, 3 and 2, 5. 5 over, then remain 2. So remaining 2 students collected 40 each. 14 flowers each. Now see the meaning of word each. Each indicates that two students collected 29 flowers each means 29, 29. Two students, no? So 29, 29. Again, two students, 23 flowers each means 23, 23. Similarly, two students, 14 flowers each means 14, 14. Okay. So the question is, if these flowers are heaped together to form, see, all the flowers were heaped together and were distributed among them equally. So all these flowers were collected together in one basket, and again those flowers were distributed equally to each of the seven students. Then how many flowers did each get? Understand? So what we have to do first, we have to find how many total flowers they have collected. And to find total flowers, what to do? We have to do addition, but not this way directly. We cannot add this, because this 29 flowers each means 29 plus 29. 23 flowers each means 23 plus 23, 2 students are there. So 14 flowers each means 14 plus 14, correct? So 43 plus 2 into 29, correct? Plus 2 into 23 plus 2 students collected 14 flowers each. So now see, 43 plus this 2, 2, 2. We can take common, and in bracket remain 29 plus 23 plus 40. This way we have to solve this equation. Okay. 2 into means 2 multiplied by 2. See, this multiply by 2, multiply by 2, multiply by 2 was common in all these three. So we have taken it common out of the bracket. Let us add this. 9 plus 3, 12 and 4. 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carried. 2 plus 2, 4 and 1, 5 and 1, 6, 66. Okay. So 43 plus 2 into 66. 6 to the 12, 1 carry, 6 to the 12 and 1, 13, 132. And plus 43, 3 plus 2, 5, 4 plus 3, 7 and 1, 175. So total there were 175 flowers. Okay. This 175 flowers, let us divide into 7 students. So 7 to the 14, 3 remain, 5 came down, 7 5s are 35. So each student got how many flowers? 25 flowers. Understand? So answer is option number 3rd, 25. One more question is there in the round number 8 only. Sixth one question. 21 upon 18 minus 7 upon 18. This was quite easy question. 55 upon 18. Okay. Is equal to what? See, this is addition and subtraction of the fraction. We can add or subtract the fraction when their denominators are same. And if you observe here, denominators are same. So this should not be your doubt. Let us do first addition. See, 21 upon 18. This here, in front of 5 upon 18, there is plus sign. So let us take it before, and minus 7 upon 18. Keep at the end. So let us add this. Or directly also we can add. Take denominator 18 comma. 21 plus 5 minus 7. 21 plus 5, 26 minus 7 upon 18. So 26 minus 7, 19 upon 18. Okay. See, answer of this question is 19 upon 18, but option it is not given. So leave that 2 marks you will get. If you have done it wrong or any option you have written, you will get 2 marks. Don't worry about this, because answer is 19 upon 18 and in option it is not given. Okay. Wrong option, sir. Don't worry. Now see here, there is one of the question number 36. See, I am reading question. Listen carefully. The train from Pune to Mumbai was going at 60 km per hour. Okay. So So this is the speed of the train, 60 kilometer per hour. Okay. It left at 3:15 p.m. and reached Mumbai at 6:45 p.m. 30 minutes were lost at the stoppage on the way. Find the distance between Pune to Mumbai. See, this is the question based on distance, speed and time. But it is directly, they have not given speed is this, this. Speed is given, but the time is not given directly. Time is, what they have given? They have given leaving time and reaching time. Okay, so at what train left the station? Left Pune at what time? 6:45 p.m. and reached Mumbai at what time? Sorry, left 3:15 and reach Mumbai at 6:45 p.m. Okay. 30 minutes were lost at the stoppage. Means 30 minutes time was it starts from Pune at 3:15 and reach Mumbai at 6:45 p.m. In between, it lost 30 minutes in stoppage. Means on the station it stopped for some time, and so totally it lost 30 minutes in stoppage. Means actual running time we have to find. Actual running time, what is that? And when once we get time, using speed and time, we can find distance. Okay, so that stoppage time is there. No, that will be subtract from the this time, this duration. Okay, so first let us find what is duration, 3:15 to 6:45. What is total duration? And from the total duration, we will subtract 30 minutes, then we will get actual time that train needed to cover the distance from Pune to Mumbai. So see here, what to do, you know, 6:45 p.m. 6:45 p.m. whenever we have to find distance, whenever we have to find duration between time, we have to convert both the times into 24 hour clock. Okay, now 3:15 p.m. means in 24 hour clock it will be 1 means 13, 2 means 14, 3 means 15. 15 minutes. Okay, hours. And this 6:45 p.m. means 3 means 15, 4 means 16, 5 means 17, 6 means 18. 18:45 hours. Okay. Now let us find duration between them. Duration means from this reaching time, we will subtract starting time. 45 minutes and 15 minutes. You can subtract them, okay? 45 is greater than 15, so 5 minus 5 is 0, 4 minus 1, 3, and 8 minus 5, 3, 1 minus 1, 0. So 3 hours 30 minutes is the duration that train has taken to cover distance from Pune to Mumbai. But see, in this 3 hours 30 minutes, 30 minutes that train has taken for stoppage. So that will not come, 30 minutes will not come in the actual time. So from this, let us subtract the 30 minutes of stoppage. Okay. So 0, 0, and 3. So exactly that the time needed to cover the distance between Pune to Mumbai is 3 hours. Okay. So time, actual time, let us write. So you understand actual time is 3 hours. Okay. So now we have speed and we have time. Let us find distance. So distance is equal to speed multiplied by time, you know, formula. So 60 kilometer per hour into 3 hours. Hours cancel. 63 is 180 kilometer. Okay, so 63 are 180 kilometers. So the distance between Mumbai to Pune or Pune to Mumbai is 180 kilometer. Okay. So this much doubts we have cleared. If you have any other doubts, you can send me. I'll make video and I'll send you. Okay. So thank you.